you can tell everybody. Yeah, you can tell everybody. Go ahead and tell everybody. I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. Yes, I am, yes, I am, yes, I am. I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. I believe every lie that I ever told. Paid for every heart that I ever stole. I played my cards and I didn't fold. Well, it ain't that hard when you got sold. Somewhere I heard that life is a test. I've been through the worst, but I still get my best. God made my mold different from the rest. Then he broke that mold, so I know I'm blessed. Stand up now and face the sun. Won't hide my tail or turn and run. It's time to do what must be done. Be a king when kingdom comes. Well, you can tell everybody. Yeah, you can tell everybody. I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. Well, you can tell everybody. Yeah, you can tell everybody. Go ahead and tell everybody. I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. Yes, I am, yes, I am, yes, I am.
Hands down, Mr. Brown.
Mr. Magnum, who has a very good sense of humor, but you gotta catch him at the right day. Because if it's not, he'll rip your head off. And then I have to say Mr. Cunningham.
Funniest teacher of prep. I think Mr. Canyon.
Who I think the funniest teacher of prep is? I would say probably Mr. Miss. Mr. Miss is pretty funny.
Mr. Mancini.
Mr. Miss.
Well, he's a teacher of life. So that qualifies him.
Tony Canuel.
That would be Mr. Dristow. He can eat better than anybody here.
Who do I think the funniest teacher at prep is? Oh, definitely Mr. Tallis. Take a look at him.
I think the funniest teacher is Sensei. Is also known as Mr. Dave Driscoll.
Funniest teacher at prep. Let's see. Mr. Miss?
Who is the funniest teacher at prep? I don't know. Can I say myself?
I think the funniest teacher is Dave Driscoll. He's always able to come out with a snappy line, and you have to really listen to what he's saying.
I think Mr. Canuel is pretty funny.
No doubt. Funniest teacher at prep? Kevin Carey.
The person that makes me laugh the most is Mrs. Evans. I would have to say that's a close tie between Mr. Cashman and Mr. Carey.
No idea.
Funniest teacher is probably Mr. Bramble.
Funniest teacher at Fairfield Prep. I think it's a cross, you know, I gotta choose between among Frank Bramble, who I think is hilarious. Miss Brooks.
Funniest teacher at prep, hands down, Miss Muma.
I would have to say, on a good day, Mr. Chesbro. On a bad day, Mr. Hellstern.
Oh Lord, that's hard to say. But for me personally, it's Tom Shea.
Clearly, Mr. Hellstern.
The funniest teacher at prep besides me, you mean?
Yes.
That's a toss-up. I'd say it's probably a very close tie between Mr. Carey and Geeks.
Mr. Carey.
Why?
Do I even have to ask that question? Answer that question, I mean. Seriously.
I was pretty much like I am now. I was a cheerleader, I was captain of the tennis team, I was very friendly and outgoing.
When I was at prep, I guess I was a lot like you guys, you know. I definitely had my fair share of problems. I had to learn my fair share of lessons from Mr. Brennan and Mr. Magden.
I was a bro.
Explain.
I was actually not an athlete, I was kind of intellectual, I was into music and arts and so forth, but I enjoyed high school a lot. It was a great time, especially junior year. Work hard.
I was very focused, athletically and academically.
I enjoyed high school. High school, I was really involved in Model United Nations, student government, politics stuff in high school.
I worked hard. I got really good grades. I studied, but I had a great group of friends and had a lot of fun. Also.
Oh God, I was a goody two-shoes and never got into trouble.
What was I like in high school? I was very similar to the man that you see in front of you today, only a little bit more full of myself, if that's possible. Oh man, I just thought that like I ran this play.
As a freshman?
I had slightly not as great hair, but I was a student first. A soccer player, second. My ukulele band was top of the school, and all around sharp guy, I would say.
Oh, I was a total nerdy dweeby. Oh God, yeah.
I just told you I was a huge loser.
Why?
Why? Because I hung out with Mr. Carey.
I was very good. I was a nerd. And I went to the same high school my father taught in, so guess what? I was really, really good.
I was active. I was definitely active. I had a really good core group of girlfriends. I went to Mercy, so it was all-girls, single-sex school. We were involved. I played three sports, field hockey, track, and lacrosse in the spring. So active, I guess. Good student.
I think I was pretty much a nerd in high school. Kind of shy.
I was pretty outgoing, social, enjoyed being parts of clubs, not athletic. I've never been athletic, but I like to study a little. I wouldn't say I was the most scholarly student, but I did okay in high school.
I was, I was an athlete. I played baseball and basketball. I didn't really take academics too seriously until junior year, which was a mistake because my GPA freshman and sophomore year wasn't great.
Everyone thinks you're funny in high school. I thought I was a funny guy.
People at prep accept each other. There's a lot of great camaraderie here at prep and a lot of good opportunities to meet new people. It's an open, accepting environment with lots of opportunities for growth.
What makes prep different? Well, certainly the Jesuit charism, our brotherhood, our belief in men for others, and I think community. Community makes us unique.
Fairfield Prep is a different place because we value the education of the whole person. So I think that this is a place where we really encourage guys to grow and develop as human beings and as young men. And, you know, prep sports and, yeah, that too.
Prep is a very unique school because we have a number of very talented individuals, students from A to Z up and down. They have sports talent, school talent, art talent, just the whole package.
We talk about brotherhood, but the fact of the matter is you gotta live it. And I think in some ways you either get on board with it or you don't hear it. So that makes it a little bit different.
It's different because there is a sense of brotherhood. You see it with victories, you see it with tragedies, and you see it in the hallways on a daily basis within the different grades. And in the classroom, there's just a sense of camaraderie that the students have with one another, and it's a really great place to teach.
What makes prep different is the brotherhood that is established and the family and community that you grow into. And learn to love.
It's different because, number one, it has the best students in the whole world right here with us. Best boys ever. But most importantly, it's Jesuit, and we walk in the footsteps of St. Ignatius Loyola, and there's nothing better.
It's been said a lot, but it is the brotherhood is really a big part of it. The school that I went to in Pennsylvania, we had the sixth man, is what the cheering section was called, whereas prep, it's the bomb squad, but I mean, it's a big part of it. It separates us from even some of the schools that are Catholic.
I think the students that are here, when I watch them stand up and take care of each other, it makes me very proud. And I don't know if you find that every place. And obviously the religious part of the school, too.
Different.
Ooh,
makes prep different? Probably the camaraderie that you get between all the young men so quickly. Everyone's in the same boat, so to speak, and everyone tries to help each other out.
Just what I said about the everything that has to offer, I don't know if there are too many other schools who offer the amount of retreats and service experiences, things like El Salvador, Ecuador, Kairos.
The camaraderie, it's a guy thing, it's a guy's school, friendships forever, religious atmosphere of the school makes it different than any other school, and a great deal of freedom here. There's a great deal of freedom here at Prep, and that's what produces our student body. It gives them a sense of ownership.
Energetic.
Afraid.
Subhuman.
Toads.
Oh, it's Calibax.
Invisible to me.
Naive.
Awful.
Crazy.
Varied.
Immature little boys. Very immature little boys.
This girl who was gorgeous, blonde, cheerleader, actually cheerleader for the BC High basketball team.
Oh, definitely a disaster. Yeah, she was nervous, fumbling around. I think I slammed her her arm in the car door, things like that.
My first date in high school was great. She was one hot young woman.
Was there a second one?
My second date. In my,
no, with her.
No, there was never a second date.
Why not?
No.
Why not?
She didn't like me. She thought there was something wrong with me. But then I ended up going out with somebody else, and that woman, that young girl, became my wife.
My first date, I went out with a student from Xavier, and we went to dinner and a movie, and that's all I really can remember.
Was there a second date?
There was. I dated that student for a couple years during my high school career until he left to go to college.
I'm sorry.
That's okay.
That was a long time ago. I really don't remember.
Oh God, the hot, steamy romances I've had. No. And only in the sense that I had people that I felt very... Andrea Jensen. I don't know what Andrea's married name is, and she's now, going to be 70. But... Andrea was my heartthrob for 8th grade, and then she wasn't important.
I was way too much of a loser to go on dates in high school.
I didn't date in high school.
So what, did you mingle?
Mingle?
Yeah, mingle with the girls.
What is that, a word from the 60s? That's even before my time.
Oh, good Lord! I don't remember. It was a long time ago. I don't remember that. I'm sorry.
It was a train wreck.
Explain.
No thanks.
Get involved, have a great time. You got 4 years, it only happened once, it'll be over before you know it.
Current freshmen need to really manage their time, stay organized, and take your tests and quizzes more seriously than you did in middle school.
Don't be satisfied.
Give up. You're sunk. There's absolutely no hope.
Stop being awful.
Current freshman, get involved.
Study.
Get involved. But you've heard that so many times by now, but get involved.
Take advantage of everything that Prep has to offer. So don't... If you're an athlete, don't solely concentrate on sports. Take advantage of things like Kairos, Urban Plunge, the service experiences that we offer, the service retreats. Tons of different clubs and activities that you can get involved with. Take advantage of those.
Do the best thing. Do everything now, because you don't want to look back and say, I wish I could have studied in my freshman year. I wish I did better in my freshman year. Do it now. Because it gets better till your senior year. It gets a little bit easier.
Find that focus, stop being aimless.
when I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing.
I don't make children mad. That's not my job.
So what is your job, inflicting pain on the students, or?
How'd you know?
I believe it was in last year's video that you said a little murder goes a long way.
Oh, it does, as long as they don't find the body.
Do you have specific methods to cover that up?
No. I don't. Trade secrets are never given. I told you, I copyright everything.
So you're like a magician, almost.
Yes, you can call me Houdini Hellstern. That's fine. Yeah, that's fine. That one's good.